What we have found locked in these ice cores is evidence of a cataclysmic climate shift which occurred around 10,000 years ago. The concentration of these natural greenhouse gases in the ice cores indicates that runaway warming pushed the planet into an ice age which lasted 2 centuries.
I'm confused. I thought you were talking about global warming, not an ice age.
Yes, it is a paradox, but global warming can trigger a cooling trend. Let me explain. The Northern Hemisphere owes its temperate climate to the North Atlantic Current. Heat from the sun arrives at the equator and is carried north by the ocean. But global warming is melting the polar ice caps and disrupting this flow. Eventually, it will shut down. And when that occurs, there goes our warm climate.
Excuse me. When do you think this could happen, Professor? When?
I don't know. Maybe in 100 years, maybe in 1,000. But what I do know is that if we do not act soon, it is our children and our grandchildren who will have to pay the price.
And who's going to pay the price of the Kyoto Accord? It would cost the world's economy hundreds of billions of dollars.
With all due respect, Mr. Vice President, the cost of doing nothing could be even higher. Our climate is fragile. At the rate we're burning fossil fuels and polluting the environment, the ice caps will soon disappear.
Professor Hall, our economy is every bit as fragile as the environment. Perhaps you should keep that in mind before making sensationalist claims.
Well, the last chunk of ice that broke off was about the size of the state of Rhode Island. Some people might call that pretty sensational.
Here at the Global Warming Conference in New Delhi, where if you can believe your eyes, it's snowing.